by the WBC in December of 1975. He served in the role until the time of his death on January the 16th, 2014 at the age of 82. During his time, the WBC sanctioned over 1,100 title bouts and 300 boxers won world titles. But most importantly, Mr. Jose Suleiman loved the sport of boxing, but what he really loved was his fighters. He really cared about them. His son, Mauricio Suleiman, is the current president of the WBC, and he is here to accept his award. Jose Suleiman, el ex presidente del Consejo Mundial de Boxeo, se unió al Consejo Mundial de Boxeo en 1968 y rápidamente ascendió. Fue elegido para el presidente del Consejo Mundial de Boxeo en diciembre de 1975. Ocupó este puesto hasta el momento de su muerte, el 16 de enero del 2014, a la edad de 82 años. Durante su tiempo en el Consejo Mundial, sancionó más de 1,100 peleas de títulos y 300 boxeadores ganaron títulos mundiales. Pero lo más importante es que el señor José Suleiman amaba el deporte del boxeo, pero lo que realmente amaba eran sus peleadores. Su hijo, Mauricio Suleiman, es el actual presidente del Consejo Mundial de Boxeo. Está aquí para aceptar su premio. Gracias.
Every single name of everyone who is here, but Rich Marotta will kick me out of the room if I start going. I feel very humbled to be here to represent my father. There are so many champions in the room, and they all know what each one of you fighters meant to him. He always saw the fighters as his kids and his daughters. To have my mother here, my sisters, my brothers, my nephews, my sons, my wife, members of WBC, friends from many parts of the world here joining us to celebrate my father's legacy is very special. The only thing I can say is that I grew up as the son of the president of the WBC when there was no fax, no email, no telephone, no cell phone, no social media. It took him to travel the world to open the doors of this organization to the world. And I lived how he had to be the president, how hard he would take on the toll of every day. Now I am the president and I have social media, telephone, cell phone, but it's still hard. We have a great responsibility, but there's only one thing that matters. It's a fighter before, during, and after the days of glory, the days of the ring. So I will continue the legacy of Jose Suleiman. And it is a great pride. I want to thank the Nevada Boxing Hall of Fame, unbelievable work, Rich, Michelle, and the great staff that works without any compensation, without anything to gain, just to service our great sport. Thank you so very much, and God bless you all.
Oh,
had in his mind things that happened that were regrets due to the boxing happenings at those times. In July of 2003, Fernando Vargas defeated Fitz Vanderpool in a WBC final elimination. Very unfortunately, Fernando was injured and was out of the ring for the whole 2004. He came back, and at the time he had to be, there was a mandatory challenger, but he fought directly against the WBC champion who had relinquished the title, Javier Castillejo. He defeated Castillejo. He would have become a WBC world champion, but it did not happen. Through the WBC Board of Governors, a special request, special vote, I would like to present with my brother Pepe the official WBC green and gold belt to Fernando Vargas, who will go back to the records as a WBC champion, super welterweight champion.
I want to say that, man, I'm thankful because I won my belt. You know what I mean? I fought Castillejo and I beat him. And now, you know, I got my belt that I always wanted. I went, this is a Mexican belt. And so everybody knows this is a Mexican belt. I got my Mexican belt and my boys are going to have the Mexican belt too. Thank you.
Thank you, Fernando.
Ellie Seckback reporting.
But ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Seckback reporting.
ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Seckback reporting.